now, the Crypt Keeper of Creepy, the provocative Prince of the Tweens, the Nightmare from Neptune, it's Zabujard!
Hey guys, we're Do Erks. I'm accepting phone calls. Call in at 1-800-555-ZABUJARD. Caller, you're on the air. Hey, caller, you can't talk like that. You're dead. You get off the air right now. Yeah, that guy calls here all the time, and I don't know what to do about it. So call in. We got more calls coming through, guys.
Hey, guys. I just got out of the bath. I'd recommend baths if you guys have a bathtub, because I've been doing baths for about a month or two now, and I like baths. I've told you guys lately that I've become a bath boy, a bath neat, and I'm proud of that, and I'm gonna probably keep doing that, because I like baths, because they're nice baths. You know, I had a doctor. I need to get a new doctor. I'm getting pain in my chest and my arms. I'm worried I'm gonna have a heart attack. Or as they would say in Among Us, a fart attack. Farts on you sucks up to the fucking floor. I had a doctor. And doctors are lying. Piece of shit niggers, because doctors are liars, because they always tell you that you haven't had enough water to drink for the day. Even if you had 69 gallons of water, they would tell you that you didn't have enough water for the day. And that's why doctors are retarded idiots, and you shouldn't listen to them. You should listen to me, because you do have enough water a day, trust me. You don't have to have a billion gallons of water every day. It's just cock sucking bullshit, nigger faggot fucking dog shit, stupid shit. You don't need that much water, you really don't. Plus, my old doctor, he was a really good therapist, but he was a crappy doctor because he would always tell me to get the poisonous snake venom VAXX. And I would always say, no, I'm not getting that. I'm not getting that poisonous dog shit. I bet if I called him on the phone today, if he's still alive, he's really old, he'd still say, oh, you need to get the VAXX. You need to get the VAX. It's safe and effective. So he was a retard doctor, but he was a good therapist, so it's just one of those things. So, you know, I was thinking about lately, this is a trip to think about, okay? If we're not in the end times, which I think we are, but it's interesting to think about the opposite. Like, what if we aren't? What if this big old world keeps on spinning round, you know? I mean, this world doesn't spin. I hate that I use that phrase, but what if this realm continues? You know, who knows how long this realm has been around, you know? Thousands of years? Hundreds of years, thousands of years, whatever. Is it naive of me to think that it will end in my lifetime? You know, is that naive to think? Maybe that is a little naive, honestly. Think about it. Maybe that is a little naive. So maybe it's more important to focus on self-sufficiency as much as you guys can. I'm not kidding. Growing your own food and water from a well. You don't need anything else. Well, I mean, I think you need prayer, right? You know, a Bible wouldn't hurt. A Torah wouldn't hurt, you know, but some Jesus Christ wouldn't hurt, but all you need, if this world keeps on spinning around, if this realm continues past the next 5 years, 2 years, 10 years. If this world somehow doesn't end, if Jesus doesn't come back, if the heart positive doesn't happen, I do think that those things will happen very soon, but it's interesting to think the opposite. What if those aren't going to happen? Because if those aren't going to happen, then I don't know what I'm going to do. The most important thing in the post-normal world, quote-unquote, will be self-sufficiency, because everyone else will have to take the mark and go to hell, right? Like the Bible says. So in order to not do that, and if we have to stay on this realm for our whole lives, you know, considering we don't die of poison that they're pumping in the air 24/7, or the poison that they were putting in people's bodies 24/7 for the last few years, if we are able to live a long life here in this realm, and this realm doesn't end, it doesn't be destroyed, then self-sufficiency is the most important thing you can do, and prayer. I'm not kidding. Those two things. And repentance. Those three things. Food, water, prayer, repentance, friends, family, all that stuff, you know, those are going to be really important. Because nothing in this world really is very important, you know, video games aren't important in the grand scheme of things, you know, if you cut the world record at Mario Super Faggio Fucker Fuck 64 or whatever, you know, it doesn't matter. It really doesn't matter. You know, if you've made the most games in history, like I have, I've made over 1,000 games, I've made more than anyone in history, it really doesn't matter. It doesn't really matter very much. What really matters is survival. And if you want to survive, you're going to need food, water, prayer, maybe a little bit of entertainment. I'm talking about a deck of cards, a board game, whatever, something. And you're going to need endurance. You're going to need motivation, inspiration, motivational. You're going to need pictures that you can print out and put on your wall, your favorite memes, your favorite pictures of you and your family, whatever it is. Things that'll keep you going when this world, which is currently, I call it hell 2.0, but when this becomes pretty much hell 1.2, when it gets that much closer to Sheol. It's going to get way closer. It's going to get way closer to real hell. Because this right now, this is like hell 1.5. Or no, this is like hell 2.0. But when this becomes like hell 1.1, think about how hard it is going to be to survive. Right now, we're living on easy mode. This world's about to turn into very hard mode. In video game terms, you have to understand that. And so none of us are ready and prepared for what's going on, unless you're Amish, then you might do okay. Which this is why, one of the reasons why I wish I was born Amish, because they have no retards, they have no cancer, they have no autism, they have the Lord, they have prayer, they don't have gay technology, they're not addicted to phones and technology and water and food, fast food and tap water and all this gay shit, right? That we take for granted from the Lord. Everything is a blessing from the Lord. Remember that. When you have a shower, when you have a bath, when you have a tasty meal, pray to God, thank Him for the meal. Say, I am unworthy of this. Straight up, this is a blessing from the Lord, and everything is a blessing from Him. Blessed be He, as they say in Judaism, they say, Blessed be He, I think. Blessed be He, I'm pretty sure. There's 72 names in Hebrew for the Lord, one of them being, I think, Hashem. A lot of Jews use that word for God, I believe. So Hashem. Anyways, I am trying to learn Hebrew. Slowly, very slowly. But I hope I can stick with it. So wish me luck in learning Hebrew. So that I can dissect the Bible and the Zohar in Hebrew after I learned Hebrew, hopefully to get closer to the Lord. That's the reasoning behind it, in case you're wondering. Because the first language God created and spoken to was Hebrew, probably, and the last one was English. And Jesus says, I am the first and the last, I think. Meaning Jesus is the Old Testament and the New Testament, probably. Or that he is Hebrew and English. Think about it, the first and the last, think about it. Not hard to figure this out when you have the Holy Spirit talking to you. I was watching a football stadium the other day and I thought about the word stadium. Stay dumb. I mean, it's so easy. You go to the grocery store to get your fast food dog shit groceries. It's called a grocery store because it's gross. All the words give clues to the hell that we're trapped in right now. Every word, stadium, stay dumb. I mean, it's just it's so easy. Only a fucking dumb nigger retard idiot can figure this crap out, like, seriously. It's so easy. Just use your fucking brain, and then you'll figure it out. And pray about it and stuff. What did I have to say? I have to say one more thing. To say one more thing, but now I can't remember what it was. What was it? I got distracted. It doesn't matter. I think I covered a decent amount of topics that I wanted to cover. I consider taking a bath. I've been giving bath tips on this channel for a few weeks now. Cover the bath in a plastic tarp. It'll keep the steam in. You can buy a plastic tarp on eBay for $10, $5. But a zero water filter, but I don't have a pitcher for it, so I can't even use it. It's very cringe. Get yourself a Sawyer Mini. It's a lifelong filter that can filter out bacteria. It lasts forever. I don't think it can filter out chemicals. For chemicals, you're going to need a harder filter. You're going to need a zero water or a Berkey. Berkeys are extremely expensive, so I'd recommend a zero water. You can wash out your zero water and maybe reuse it. Inside of many zero water filters are ions, and ions are what filter chemicals and stuff, and viruses, bacteria, and heavy metals. I don't know what else to say. I ordered some Chinese trash, like always, like usual. I ordered some water filters, and I ordered a board game called... What's it called? I ordered 50 pictures off of snapfish.com for $7.50. Just my favorite memes and my favorite pictures on printed, glossed-up photos that I'm going to tape to the wall. So that I'll have some cool pictures to look at in the end times, when there's no more electricity. I'm kind of a huge genius, I know. I ordered, a board game called, what is it called? Keyforge. It's called Keyforge. It's by the creators of Magic the Gathering. It's called Keyforge. I have no friends in my town to play the game with. There's a card game store near me I can go to hang out with possible fat neckbeard virgins who like card games, and maybe I could play with them, but I'm pretty shy about making friends at 31 years old. Should I go to a card game shop and play with other people card games? Tell me in the comments, maybe I should, I don't know. It's a little bit of a drive, though. I don't like driving. It's like 3 minutes away. It's not very far, I know. It's not very far. Hope you guys are doing good. Hope you guys are doing great. It's been raining here. I didn't go outside today. I'm gonna buy some mosquito netting. You can put mosquito netting over a big barrel, turn it into a rain barrel, and then filter that. And boil the water if you want to. Filter that through a water filter or a Sawyer Mini or a Life Straw. And at least it would get rid of the viruses, bacteria. But I don't know if it would be safe to drink because it's rainwater. If you filter it through a water filter, maybe it would. I'm just worried about the chemicals that are in rainwater. I don't know how many chemicals are in rainwater because they, of course, they spray the skies 24/7. With poison through chemtrails every day. So that's probably getting into the water, the rain, the clouds, all that shit, right? Satan is poisoning us 24/7. He's working hard. And because Satan is working so hard, you guys need to work hard too. Okay? That's all I'm gonna say. Or at least work a little bit. You know? Read God's word. I don't know. Repent. Do whatever you need to do. You know, Jews don't like Jesus Christ. Jews are against Christ. I was looking up the Jewish arguments why they're against Christ, because of course I'm interested in this stuff. The three or five main reasons Jews are against Christ is because they believe that Christ needs to be a direct relative of King David, which Jesus Christ was not. He didn't have a biological father. He was born of a virgin. He's not of King David's lineage. Number one, Jews think their Messiah will be of King David's lineage. Number two, they think the Messiah will rule in an era of complete peace. Of course, when Jesus came, the world was not in peace. Number three, they think false prophets can perform miracles as well. Of course, I don't know of any other false prophets resurrecting from the dead. Unless you consider some weird Egyptian god stories like Osiris or something like that. I don't know. Did he rise from the dead? I don't really know. So they don't care about Jesus Christ resurrecting, I guess. Even though Moses didn't resurrect, Ezekiel didn't resurrect, Isaiah didn't resurrect. All the prophets of the Old Testament did not resurrect. Jews question the validity of Jesus Christ's miracles, even though, from what I can tell, a lot of people were there to witness them, so that makes no sense if there are a lot of witnesses. Number four, Jews don't like Jesus because he died and left and said that he would come back. Jews think when their Messiah comes, he will not die and then say, I'll come back to finish the job later. They think that their Messiah will quote-unquote finish the job while he's here and not leave and then come back. Interesting. Number six, Jews don't like Jesus because... What else was there? What else? The New Testament was written in Greek, not Hebrew. Paul wrote 16 of the 24 New Testament books. People know a lot about Paul, but they don't know a lot about the other apostles. The people such as Matthew, who finished his book, didn't end his book with written by Matthew. So people question if it was actually written by Matthew, for example, etc., etc. Jews like to quote a certain scripture from the Old Testament, which says, where God says, anyone who adds or subtracts from this book, meaning the Torah, is a lie. Which is what Mormons did to the New Testament, right? They added a book onto it. Which is kind of what the Christians did to the Old Testament. They added their book onto it, right? The New Testament was added to the Old Testament. The Mormon Bible was added to the original Bible, right? So, they question that. They like to have a lot of proof behind their prophets. For example, when Moses heard the voice of God for the first two commandments of the Ten Commandments, all the Jews were there to witness the first two commandments, and they were there to hear God's voice. And they said it was too much for them, so they all left and had Moses record the remaining eight commandments. But all the Jews that were alive heard God's voice in that area. And that's how they knew that Moses was a real prophet, because they all heard God speaking to Moses. So, interesting, right? Interesting stuff. What Jews, I think, fail to realize is that if you forget the Torah for 1 second, forget the holy books for 1 second, close the Torah and look with your own eyes at the world around you, look at how much Satan is attacking. Not Moses, not Ezekiel, not Isaiah, not Jonah, not Noah, but only Christ alone. Through music videos, movies, TV shows, demons, etc. Why is it that Satan hates Jesus so much more than all the other prophets? I would ask any Jew who reads the New Testament, any practicing Jew, I'd say, why do you think Satan cannot stand Jesus? Why do you think Satan hates Jesus more than any other prophet in history? Why do you think that is? And that's actually one of my biggest arguments in favor of Jesus Christ. If I think of more, I'll let you guys know. But anyways, that's all I have to say about this certain topic. And I hope you guys are having a good week. I have about, I don't know, 3 or 4 months of money left of rent. So my parents are bugging me about getting a job 24/7 because I won't be able to pay the rent very soon. I really don't want to get a job though. I hate working. And that's why I haven't worked in over a year now. I haven't worked since October of 2022. So, I haven't worked in about almost 16 months. Thank God, because working is not my cup of tea most of the time. Sometimes you can find a job that's pretty chill, don't get me wrong, but I'm just not much of a working guy.
Now it's time to have a snuggle with my very best friend in the whole wide world. You. Well, I'm glad you could come over. See you soon. Bye. The clown jumped over the moon.